babies in bars, more specifically tap rooms, is a growing trend. Tap rooms usually have great outdoor spaces, cater to a daytime crowd, with more than 1,000 breweries set to open this year alone. It will be easier than ever for you and your baby to grab a drink together. So DBL Nation, we gotta hear from you on this one. Do babies belong in bars? Please sound off.
Here we go. Brett says, bars? Absolutely not. I'm there to have a good time, not for a baby to judge my life choices. Brewery? Sure. But only before 5.
What?
Things go downhill from there. Now look, I'm kind of a hypocrite on this one because I'm like, come on, you bringing the babies to the party life? But at the same time, when I have kids, I'm gonna be sitting there playing cornhole with a baby Bjorn
yeah.
on.
Get it.
I'll ask you to hold the baby while I go take shots. How's that?
You won't be taking shots, trust me.
Really?
Trust me, you're gonna be getting up so early in the morning, you will be thinking it ain't worth it.
Yes, it is. The fact that you have to wake up early, you take shots.
Oh, man, Sam.
Wheatgrass shots. Watch. Just watch.
Take the wind out my sail.
Wheatgrass shots? I can't wait for this. All right, Michelle says no, this is only a thing because everyone has decided that drinking on a daily basis to reduce stress is a thing. Nice attitude. I like it. I have no problem with babies in breweries, like the previous person said.
Yep.
I think babies in bars are a little weird. Dive bars, anything like that. Yeah, you kind of want to have a sexy, romantic attitude. But a brewery, again, the baby Bjorn with the cornhole.
Yeah,
I'm done.
Thank you. Thank you, Tori.
Anytime, buddy.
Carissa from Facebook says, yes, as a mom that needs a drink every now and again, I think this should be acceptable. Babysitters are hard to find.
True.
Carissa, I completely agree. And also, you know what? Babysitters are very expensive. Mm. So by the time you've paid for your Uber to wherever you're going, because obviously you're having a drink, you've had a drink, you're paying for someone to sit at home and mind your child, you've then got to tip them. Before you know it, going out for one drink has turned into like over $100 and
you're
it's
right.
just not even worth it, so you don't leave. And as a parent, I'm not a parent, but I'm sure as a parent, you need to let your head down. You need to have like times where you can have a drink with your partner and not feel worried about what time is it and clock watching. So I think in certain situations, obviously if it's a nightclub and people are raving,
timing. It just depends. Mm-hmm. Justin says, I don't think kids or babies belong in high-end cocktail bars. However, craft breweries have cultivated a sense of come hang out here for a few hours on a Saturday afternoon, so they seem better for families. Completely agree. First of all, I think less judgment for parents out there. Of course, if it's late at night at a bar, your child should be in bed. But at the same time, I think when I first became a mom, you do mourn your old identity.
Of course.
You have this whole new identity. You have this whole new life. You no longer can be spontaneous. So I like the idea of having balance. And I think that would help a lot of parents out there because it's tough to kind of like mourn your old life. Why not combine the two?
But also, when you just have a baby, I mean, obviously, I've not had a child, but I've heard that from a lot of women and mums, that those first few times when you leave your child is really traumatic.
Very hard.
So, like, you want to go out and do something, but it's like trauma to leave your baby for a few months,
and you're
right?
sick of being in the house. Let me tell you, after you first have a baby, you are so sick and tired, you want to get out. Yeah. So, hey, baby Bjorn, cornhole, done.
You lost me at wheat shots.
You
replaced my shots with wheat shots.
Your wheatgrass shots, you're going to need them. You're going to need your stamina. You're going to need your energy.
Oh,
trust.